Welcome to the first episode of 1 Minute Mods. I'm your host, Ian the Junkernaut, and we're gonna make something cool. Alright. Just recently, I broke out my old Nintendo 64 since I was a youngster, and started going through and beating Zelda and some other games that were kind of on my video game bucket list. It doesn't take very long of playing a Nintendo 64 to realize, or remember, if you've played one very much before, that the controller has some pretty big issues. One thing that we can say is a really legitimate complaint on this, I think, which is that the design of the analog stick. The first one is that they wear out pretty fast, and so you can see this one has a little bit of wobble in it. It's still usable, but these do definitely get loose over time. Another big problem is just the ergonomics of it. Holding it and doing this, I mean, it feels okay if you're doing it for like 30 seconds, but if you're playing a video game for an hour or several hours, like, it literally starts to chafe your thumb raw. When you push it forwards, it pushes so far that really the only way to hold it there is to have the edge of the stick actually cutting into your thumb. Or you can have your thumb really up high, but you don't have that much grip. I started looking around, seeing if there was any way that you could mod controllers or any pieces that have been made, you know? And I was excited when I found that some company has been making and selling essentially a GameCube analog stick that is made to function with a Nintendo 64. The problem is, as I started to read more into it, is that a lot of people said that it had even more of a dead space in the middle than the N64 controller was. And as I was looking at some reviews, some people said that they actually had a lot less refined, intricate movement. So I came up with my own very cheap, very easy mod, which has basically already been done to this one. So it still is domed on top. It's not indented very much, but you can see it has a lot more grip on it. And so it's not nearly as uncomfortable because of the angle and the softness to grip, but it also gives you this rubberized texture on top. It makes it a little bit soft and a lot more grippy. So how do you do this? It's really easy. Just took a pair of $1 rubber gloves, and they've got this nice, fairly thick rubberized texture feel. You cut the tip of the glove off. Doesn't have to be very much. And mine is obviously too big. So we could trim this down, but what I'm actually going to do is keep this, and I'm going to cut another one. So this one we're going to cut off of the pointer finger, which is a little bit thinner. Now, if you don't want to have to sand down your controller, basically what you need to do is make it so that when it's pushed on here, you don't have very much hanging over, because you're going to end up with a situation where when you're pushing it as far forwards or whatever, it's not actually going to be going at full speed if you're playing a game where your character has kind of like a slow walk speed and a fast walk speed like Mario or Zelda. You can see as we test fit it, it's just going literally right to the edge of the analog stick. All we're going to do is super glue that piece onto the analog stick. Now, I would recommend using some goggles or some safety glasses, but I can tell you from somebody who's had to go to the hospital with super glue in my eye, it's not fun, and it's easier to do than you would probably think. But that is a story for another time. We're gonna put a little bit of super glue all around the top here. You wanna make sure you don't drip it down into the inner movable part at the bottom, otherwise you're gonna glue your analog stick in place, and that will be a bummer to have to fix. I am going to start to press down on the sides to try and get those to glue in place a little bit, because that's where it's going to be the most likely to want to lift up off the controller here. I'd say just a little bit more super glue around the sides. Literally ready to go right now. In my opinion, this is much more comfy to use and gives you way more grip and control than the regular unmodified analog stick. If you don't have this stuff, it's going to be like $2 to get a pair of gloves and the super glue. Doesn't, in my opinion, ruin the controller, even if you don't like it. You could still peel it off if you really wanted to, whatever. If you want to go the extra mile, all you do is you take that other piece that we cut earlier, the piece that was a little bit thicker from the middle finger, and you just do a second layer on top. But that just gives you even more grip and more contour. But Anyways, guys, this has been a 1 minute mod. I hope you liked it. If you did, please give me a thumbs up below and consider subscribing for more videos. And give me a comment if you tried this out and you liked it or you had a different suggestion for me. Anyways, guys, appreciate it. Take it easy.